idea of this book is that you can find the essence, everything that rock and roll ever wanted to be, all of its aspirations, its originality, its difference from other kinds of music or other kinds of speech, in any good rock and roll song, defined in the broadest way. So to tell the history of the music, you don't need to talk about Elvis Presley or James Brown or Otis Redding or Nirvana or Tupac Shakur or anybody that you're supposed to talk about. You can forget about the Rolling Stones. You can forget about Bob Dylan. I tried to write this book so that none of the people you have to talk about to tell this story would be in it. And I didn't quite succeed. I couldn't leave out the Beatles. But when I included the Beatles, it was only their performances of other people's songs. Their version of Money by Barrett Strong, or their version of Crying, Waiting, Hoping by Buddy Holly. So none of the big events in the history of rock and roll, no Woodstock, no Altamont, no Elvis on the Ed Sullivan Show, none of that is in this book. This book is just about diving into a song and seeing how much is there. The story of the music, the ambition, the defeats, the will to create something that wasn't there before, to make a difference, to make a record that didn't sound like anything else. Over and over again with Etta James, with Barrett Strong from Motown, Amy Winehouse, with a song from 1958 by the Teddy Bears, To Know Him Is to Love Him. The Flamin' Groovies, the dumbest name for a musical group in history, but making the perfect rock and roll song, Shake Some Action. Joy Division with Transmission. Buddy Holly with Crying, Waiting, Hoping. This Magic Moment by the Drifters. Just going from one song to another, and each of those songs and each of its story is the whole story of rock and roll. So that's how this book works. It's just 10 songs.